Internet, good morning. My name is Magnitude, and today I have a Wi-Fi battle against the Heated Mo. Got back yesterday from my house, decided I wanted to battle somebody. I enjoy this man in particular. He's a very nice guy, a humble guy, got great content. Go check out his channel. Link will be in the description. If you enjoy the video, please leave a like. Shooting for 400 likes in every Wi-Fi battle. I decided March Madness is going to spill over into April. The actual March Madness tournament spills over into April. So, and as I said in the last video, I'm picking up more hours at work. I just don't have the time to squeeze in like battle like that all the time, so I'm just going to try to get battles what I can. And then, whatever, that'll have to work out. But the same team I was running with yesterday, he has a Talonflame, Mega Charizard, Y, Latias, Jirachi, Espeon, and a Zelf. We shared a Zelf, that's kind of cool. I do love Gourgeist, I'm going to be bringing him more often. I just love the concept that is Gourgeist. But I with Manetric kind of thought he was going to lead with his, not a Zelf, but since he led with a Zelf, I figured, you know, he's probably that Stealth Rocker I saw back in 4th gen. Get that huge Intimidate because that U-turns might come. But he does get Rocks Up. I am going to hit him with a Volt Switch and do some solid damage to that itself, which I'm always a big fan of. So now I have the option to go back into my Entei. I kind of thought he was going to switch out into his Jirachi. But I figured maybe, I don't know if he is. I'm just going to not go for Extreme Speed. But it turns out I probably should have gone for Extreme Speed anyway. So I get the Stone Edge up. I figured Extreme Speed probably been a better option. I would have taken damage from his Zelf, even went to Jirachi, whatever. He goes to Espeon, and I totally misclick. I wanted to go for an Extreme Speed, but Extreme Speed and Hidden Power are on the same side of the screen, and they both have the same exact color, both being white there, and I just went for it. So, unfortunately, that was a horrible play, and I decided, you know what, he got up a Light Screen, I was going to go for a Flare Blitz, maybe something happened. End up taking out the Espeon, and in the process, I end up taking out myself Recoil, so we get a double down there, and I'm up 5-4, which is nice. He goes to Jirachi. I go into Manectric, and I just figured maybe, I don't know what kind of Jirachi he is yet, I have no idea, I get the Intimidate off, I'm just going to go for a Flamethrower, maybe do something. He goes for U-turn, showing me that he's Scarfed, which I guess is alright to know, and he's going to then go into Latias to take the Flamethrower for nothing, max special defense has to be Latias, that is ridiculous. This Volcano, which is Volcano, does almost, it's like, it's nothing, it does absolutely nothing. Going to Forgus on the predicted Fire-type maneuver, or Dragon-type maneuver, and he's going to obviously not be affected by it, and he's going to obviously be fearing the Moonblast and the double leftovers. Takes a while to get through, but he's going to switch out, go back in his Jirachi on the Moonblast, and I just decided to set up a Light Screen instead to get that support going. And I saw he was Scarfed, he's got U-turn, he's probably physical, so I decided, you know what, we're going to switch out. We're actually going to go into Gourgeist on his predicted U-turn again. But if he wants to go for Iron Head, that's fine as well. He just goes for the Iron Head, and it's going to do nothing because I'm max defense. And now I predict him to predict me to use Will-O-Wisp and go into either Talonflame or Mega Charizard. Well, regular Charizard. So I just go for a Leech Seed. And he goes in Talonflame. That Leech Seed's fantastic. And I know that I can take a non-banded Brave Bird or Flare Blitz. So I decide, you know what, we're going to stay in, because after everything else, I know I can take it. He's going to hit me with a Flare Blitz. That's going to do enough to not take me out. Knew I was going to live, and I go for a Seed Bomb. Should have just gone for a Shadow Sneak, 2 birds, 1 stone. Literally, it's 1 bird right there, because he's Talonflame. Better seeing that kind of damage, and I kind of figure I saw nothing. He might be Jolly Band. So I figure, you know, we're going to go just for a Shadow Sneak. I can probably take him out from that range, and I can. Head-to-head, just saw Gourgeist taking out a Talonflame. That is fan weak to both of his stabs, but I still took it out, which fucking I love it. Light Screen wears off, he goes in Jirachi. I don't want anything, I just want to deal as much damage as I can because he's now weak to Ghost as opposed to being neutral because of the Steel typing. And I just kind of take him out, but he's not going to take me out, so I'm going to be able to get up some more damage. He's got 3 guys, looks like I got 5. I'm going to be able to deal some more damage with Shadow Sneak, which I love. He's going to become Mega Charizard Y! And he's going to take me out, unless he obviously goes for Air Slash and misses. He decides, you know what, he's going to go for an Air Slash. I'm going to go for a Shadow Sneak to get, like I said, some more damage off. Air Slash going to take me out. Gourgeist is going to go down. However, I do have a Mega Manectric ready to go with Hidden Power Ice. But now I go for a Zelf. I figure I can take him out with Thunderbolt if he stays in. But he is, in fact, going to switch out. Going to go into his Latias to take, again, no damage. Really wish I had U-turn instead of a Nasty Plot that would have at least done something. But it's not really all that much. So now I kind of have to switch out. I don't want to take a Draco Meteor, Dragon Pulse, whatever. I do switch, go back into Florgus, which he goes for Dragon Pulse again. I am immune to that. Things are looking up. I can do solid damage to his Jirachi, though. And he can't get recovery off because he's scarfed, so I know he has to switch. He has to. So he goes in Jirachi. I go for the light screen to help me out again. I should have gone for the Moonblast instead. But either way, I switch out, going to Manectric to get that Intimidate off, as he's probably going to go for the Iron Head, which he does, in fact, go for the hold on, Intimidate first, go for the Iron Head, or he goes for the Ice Punch instead. So now I figured he was going to switch into the Latias, but he just decided to stay and go for an Ice Punch. I go for Hidden Power Ice. So that was a horrible misprediction on my part. He just did not do what I thought. And I figured, okay, now I'm going to go to his Elf. He definitely has to now switch into his Latias. He has to. So I'm just going to go for a Nasty Plot. He decides once again to stay in. And he gets a crit Ice Punch. So now I definitely can't live a second Ice Punch. So I've just made two mispredictions that I really thought he was going to switch out two times in a row. He decides to stay in two times in a row. And that is going to be just a horrible place. Not much I can say. But now he decides now he's going to switch out, I guess, on whatever. I just go for the waterfall. I get a crit waterfall, which I guess is nice. I don't know. It doesn't do that much. And I decide, yeah, we're just going to keep trying to waterfall. Whatever. I should have gone into Forgus. I really thought he was going to predict me. I got into Forgus twice. Why? I don't know why he was still going for Dragon Pulse. I thought he was going to predict me to go into Forgus for a third time. But he doesn't. And I figured, okay, now he's definitely going to predict me to go into Forgus, right? He has to. There's no way he's going to Dragon Pulse me. I'm going to be able to get it. But he goes for Dragon Pulse again. So those last couple turns, man, I just had him all wrong. I just did not think he was going to do any of those moves. I get a bulk up. Whatever. But that kind of sealed my fate right there after the bulk up and the Dragon Pulse. I figured maybe, I don't know. But either way, he just goes for Dragon Pulse. I'm going to be able to get a +1 waterfall off for some damage. It's not going to be all that much. It's going to be a little bit, I guess, but I figure, you know, maybe I could. There's a chance where I can pass a wish off to Poliwrath. And I figure if he goes to Dragon Pulse, I'm going to meet her anyway, so I might as well go into Florgus. He takes a Dragon Pulse, and I obviously am immune to it for the third time this battle. I'm immune to it. So he's going to probably go into his Jirachi. The Iron Head can't take me out, but it can, I guess, potentially flinch me, which is whatever. So he goes to Jirachi. I hit him with that Moonblast. That's not going to do that much because, you know, he's kind of resists it with the steel typing. But I figure if I can get a wish off, I can maybe if he locks up an Iron Head, maybe I can live an Iron Head. But he flinches me anyway, so that's kind of going to seal my fate completely in this match because I can't live an Iron Head. And I guess maybe if Poliwrath can live, maybe. That would be solid, but he's at 18 HP, he's going to die, so that's the battle. Hope you enjoyed that video. I made some huge misplays. I figured he was going to switch many times. He never did. So rate, comment, sub, I guess, and I will see y'all next time. Peace.